So in the last video about the market revolution, we had just taken a look at this huge cross-country network that was able to be built all across the United States that for the first time ever, ever is going to allow people who live in America to be able to, well, sell stuff and buy stuff from much further away places than had ever happened before. And those three key ingredients of the roads, the canals, and the railroads, you want to remember them in that order, roads, canals, and railroads, because chronologically, that's the order they come in. But you'll still be only about as good as some of the better A-Push students. If you want to be among the best A-Push students when it comes to the market revolution, you'll be adding that secret ingredient, the fourth thing that we add to the roads, the canals, and the railroads that make a market economy happen. It's the kind that people who aren't economic historians don't often think about. It's the idea of having the information that's necessary to make these markets happen. To know what prices are being charged in what other places along the network so that you can send your stuff to the places where it will make the most money. To be able to get the information to people there who will receive the goods and all the people along the way. Well, most of this information is being printed in simple, plain, ordinary newspapers. During, say, the 1820s, 1830s, the age of Jackson, we have the penny press developing over that time period. And it gets that name because the price of the newspaper is literally a penny at the time. And that's not the model of British newspapers. British newspapers were much more expensive. They were produced much less frequently because they were really only intended for the uppity-ups to be reading. But the information that you need about prices and schedules and everything else in a market is going to happen through the newspapers that grow in tremendous proportion over, say, the 1820s, the 1830s. This information is what makes that network work. And every part along the network is producing its own newspapers. And newspapers, thanks to some actual foresight by Congress. Can you believe this? Congress actually did something right. Well, newspapers could go really cheaply through the post office. And, well, postmasters could exchange them for free. And so, without the information necessary to make these networks work, they wouldn't work. And so it's important to remember that when things could get around, like with the speed of a postal rider carrying newspapers, that was pretty good. And then in the early 1840s, when we made it even faster with the invention of the telegraph and people being able to transmit information much faster, they're still going to be depending a lot on the newspapers, but when you really have things where time is of the essence, the telegraph is going to be faster information spread than ever in human history. And along a network that is as big as the one that we saw, I'm sure you can imagine that it's not just the goods, but the information being able to travel cheaper, more profitably, and faster. That's what the speed of information has to do with the speed of the roads, the canals, and the railroads in the market revolution.